I'm on a mission to full clear floor 12's Spiral Abyss with each and every character with a team tailored to that character. That said, some characters are harder to use than others. KLEE is a character with an extremely high skill ceiling, and most of her strength is locked behind understanding Genshin Impact's ins and outs. Tight animation cancels, aura management, and proper rotations are critical to maximizing KLEE's potential. Here's the problem. I suck at the game. Be sure to drop a like and let me know down below which character you'd like to see next. For now though, let's start with learning the very basics with KLEE. So as I've been studying up on KLEE, it seems like one of the most important things to learn first up is her animation cancels. If you're unfamiliar with the idea of an animation cancel, I feel like most people are pretty familiar with how Ka-Ching works. Basically, her charge attack is like her big thing, right? And you can cancel basically any of Ka-Ching's attacks into a charge attack, so normal attack, normal attack, normal attack. But if at any point you start holding charge, it cancels your normal attack into it, right? Another example is when you're switching characters, if you switch immediately into their burst, that's also a form of cancel, right? So for instance, if you're just kind of attacking and then boom, that's also a form of cancel, right? And you might have seen me do Yoimiya's animation cancels a lot. When you're shooting Yoimiya's normal attack string like this, on the fifth shot there, you can do a couple different things. There are dash cancels. There are also aim cancels, which is what I usually do. So this is just you pressing R twice. You can also hold left mouse button to enter charge mode for just a second, but that's a bit harder and I'm not really used to doing that. That's kind of necessary for some other characters as aim cancels, but not for Yoimiya. So KLEE has a lot of different cancels that you have to learn. Kalos users in general just have very slow normal attack strings, so you can see how long this is taking. This is me mashing. And it's pretty slow, right? I'm not gonna pretend I'm gonna learn all the crazy complicated stuff, but at least the simple ones I can do. So for instance, we're basically just gonna use the first attack in the normal attack string. So this, where she throws the ball, that's the only part of the normal attack string we're ever gonna wanna use. If we're holding forward while we're doing the normal attack and we press it at the right time, you'll see that we just throw twice. Instead of getting her second animation, which is that right hand toss, we just get two left hand tosses. And so that's the first step. In general, because of how KLEE's pounding surprise works, we're going to want to get a couple normal attacks in before we cancel into her charge attack, but her charge attack is a huge chunk of her damage. So in general, what you're gonna see me do is three normal attacks, cancel into the charge attack. You saw that I jumped there. Otherwise, if you don't jump, KLEE's charge attack is kind of like that. You see how long it takes me before I can start walking? You just get locked in. So you really need to cancel that charge attack animation. And the way that I've found most comfortable is to just jump. Basically, once you start seeing the flower, you can jump. But if you jump too early, then it just cancels the entire animation, right? So you see that it's just like, this is me doing the charge attack, right? It's not until the flower shows up I can actually cancel it and it'll come out. You're gonna see me do this three string a lot. You can jump cancel her normal attack really early, like you see this. I don't know how often I'll do this necessarily, but it might be important. I think the biggest thing about these cancels isn't so much like maximizing my damage output, but more like maneuvering KLEE around so that I don't get blown up and really get used to knowing when to use which cancels. Obviously, the safest way to do it is dash canceling, like you get invincibility frames, but it takes a lot of stamina as opposed to like jumping, which doesn't take stamina, right? Obviously, these walk cancels don't take any stamina either. I play fighting games, and like one of those things that you learn in fighting games is you've got to learn how to do your combos in the lab first in training mode. You just got to get down the input, and then once you're comfortable in training mode, try it on like a moving enemy. So we might take this around. You might see some footage of me terrorizing Monsat or something. Just trying to get used to doing this without really thinking about it. Because it's one thing to be focusing while just kind of walking around in the grass, but while I'm trying to do actually, you see how while I was talking, I couldn't do the charge attack cancel? Exactly, right? Like I need to get used to doing that kind of stuff. And then the last step, once you've gotten used to doing it on moving enemies, just take it out into the real world, right? In a fighting game, that would be against other players. You just gotta get ready to mess it up in a real game. In this case, it'll probably just be us taking it to Spiral and getting a couple reps in. But yeah, enjoy some footage of me terrorizing Monsat, I guess. Honestly, if I should be practicing anything, it's practicing talking while doing this. It's so long since I've been in Mondstadt. Wow. This takes me back to like, what was it, 2020? Is that when this game came out? 2021? Fun fact, my first ever 5-star was actually Ka-Ching. It was funny because my friends had an inside joke. All of them kept pulling ka-ching, and it was like every single one of us in our friend group had a ka-ching, except the one person who really wanted ka-ching. Which was Emmy, by the way, of C6R5 Farina fame. He ended up actually fishing for her in standard banner, which is just crazy to me. Absolute wild boy. Oh, I guess there's no harm in trying. This should be a really strong team. I'm not really sure if the rotations will work out that well. Everybody kind of has really short burst lengths. We can consider Venti because he has a longer burst, but I think for right now at least I'll just try Kazuha. Also, my Kazuha is just C2, so he's better than my Venti, but all right, let's just give it a shot, I guess, whatever. I am missing out on a Kazuha skill because I have, again, whoops, I didn't do the skill. Oh my god, I died in one hit! I exploded! We did an enormous amount of damage though, look at that. No. I paid attention this time. Our energy's just a little bit low. Uh-oh. I heard he's actually quite a bit low. I guess it does matter for me to get that one last Kazuha in. Whew. Okay, so the problem with this rotation is that by the time I reach KLEE, our Bennett's burst is already over. I think I might just be lacking energy recharge, but it's not quite working. I also don't really know what the rotation should be, so let's try a different team. This team looks a lot easier to use and should probably be pretty explosive in terms of damage. We could also just do a classic vape comp, but we can try that if this doesn't work. I don't know when. Maybe I should do it like here. Oh, my shields got evaporated. Where did they go? Yeah, this team kind of lacks explosivity, huh? Yeah, our damage isn't very good. Okay, well that didn't work either. All right, well there's no harm in giving Venti a shot. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that twice. Well. Oh my god, my face! Why won't you die? Thank you. I don't reach? Oh my. I can't reach! Okay, Venti's definitely not the pick. Oh my, I can't reach them with KLEE! I should have never leveled up my Venti! I can't believe 3 years later in 2024, we're still having the issue where level 90 Venti is a problem. I can't believe this crap. Are you serious? Buff my boy, what did they do to him? All right, we can try some classic Burgeon comp then. How about that? I know it looks like I'm just avoiding the easiest team, which is like just building freaking Vaporize KLEE, but I don't know. Maybe it's because I play Yoimiya, but like that just seems so boring. My face. Because then it just becomes a Yaelon showcase. I don't want another Yaelon showcase. That's every Yoimiya video. Okay, we should just try to. Okay, I really need to stay standing next to the freaking jellyfish. Oh my god, we take so much damage so fast. I actually think I should change my order a little bit just so that I'm like spending enough time on characters that aren't KLEE to wait out this freaking. Yeah, there you go. Because they don't do as much damage outside of that. Their Dendro mode, so. This is looking solid. Okay. Oops, I didn't hold. I should probably, after this rotation, spend some time to just heal with Kokomi.
let's just do that. There we go. Ow. Ah, I'm just mashing. There's no skill. Ah, no, Kazuha! Admittedly, I'm just getting carried by my very powerful C2 R1 characters here, but I do think this is kind of the play. Just don't die. That's all you have to do, Soran, is not die, and you're good. Okay, we made it. And if we made it, that's all that we needed, baby. Alright, let's just plow through this enemy real quick. Easy peasy. This team is crazy, by the way. Navia, you can just put Navi on anything and she just works. Alright. We should figure out a way to heal. Oh my god, I took so much damage. Was that just a huge amount of Burgeons? Did I just take Burgeon? I'm pretty sure I blew myself up. I'm not even gonna lie. Let's just do this. This is fine. Look at how much bloom damage we're doing, by the way. Okay, perfect. Dendro continues to prove to be absolutely busted, huh? Really, Nahida is proving to be absolutely busted. Okay, now I know these guys hit like a truck, so we should be very careful here. But as long as we're careful, we should be okay. Ow. Oh! I see you! I'm not falling for that! Relax. Take it slow. I'm gonna switch into Kokomi Heal! Okay. I'm just gonna stay here while that's going on. Thank you. See ya. The KLEE team is going crazy, but I also feel like I'm just not actually using KLEE. She's just... I'm just burgeoning. Get back here. I'm gonna keep swinging. Yep. Because that way we get our fifth attack. Eat this. We could Navia burst, but I don't think it matters. We're gonna kill here. Yeah. Wow, look at our health, too. We're in a good spot. Ow. Oh my god. I like this. Honestly, this is showcasing a really important thing about the difference between what's considered great and what's practical. The difference between optimal and realistic. It's hard to argue that Kokomi is optimal here, but the fact that I don't have to care about my health is, or rather, I guess I still care about my health, but she's making it a lot easier, right? Now we are taking longer to do this than I would like, but it's mostly because I'm trying to choose very safe rotations rather than just attacking. And also because our energy is a little off, but ow. 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 Stop! Go away! And now we just wail on it. Alright. Whoa, I forgot jumping makes you do that. It interrupted my shield. That's not great. Let's just make sure I don't get hit. Oh, I thought you can't dodge through that? Is it just longer? I probably just dodged too early. You know, that wouldn't have happened if I got my shield. Where is he? Is he behind me? Oh my god, he's behind me! I didn't realize the Anemo characters can pull in the Jumpty Dumpties. That's actually a really funny synergy. It's kind of like Kira's Cat Bombs. I guess Kira's Cat Bombs are kind of like Jumpty Dumpties is more accurate, huh? I wish I could see. I just have to trust I'm hitting. Okay, this time I'll get my shield off and things are going to be okay. Literally just doing this to break its shield quickly. Okay, there we go. Rip it apart. I canceled. I canceled too early. All right. GG's, baby. See ya. Get good, scrub. Okay, so, I mean, it worked. We got our full clear. But we were definitely just carried by my other characters, so I don't really feel great about that. Don't get me wrong. I mean, Genshin is, at the end of the day, a team-building challenge, and, like, KLEE is an incredible Burgeon enabler. But I don't know. I feel like that was just, like, that was kind of Nahida carry, if anything. That was Nahida Kazuha carry. I guess just out of curiosity, let me just try this. What the heck do I do on the other half now? The funnies? You love seeing some fat Yelan vapes. Ah! Neat. Alright, well, now I kind of just feel like I'm being carried by Yelan. Yelan is that just kind of character. Yeah, this team doesn't quite have the amount of crowd control I would like. I mean, Yoimiya is strong, but I don't know about this one. It was close. It was actually very close. Whatever. Anyway, you get the idea. So I guess we can try KLEE on the other half as well. I do think that in general, just like a vape melt comp is usually the best way to boss kill. I kind of like Diona on this half. Just for the extra damage. And then on this half, I mean, I could just like hyper bloom. But I want to play Yoimiya. Whatever, I'll just play Yoimiya. Like, I don't know if Kira can tank through these. We could do mono pyro. Oh, that's pretty nutty. I'm not even gonna lie. That's actually really sick. This, I don't know how we break the pyro abyss mage shield, but as soon as we get through that, we're Gucci gang. I actually think I take the HP just to buff Kira's shield a tiny bit further. Oh my god. Damage. Oh my damage. Oh my god, my shield! this might work. This might be the play, actually. It's a pretty cool team, at least. I just need to look. The moment my shield breaks, yeah, we're just switching out. Literally the second it breaks, I'm out, bro. Oh my holy damage! We don't have to do anything fancy. We can just... The Mono Pyro is, like, actually really strong with a BB set. Like, don't... I think, like, we kind of beam on it, which is fair, but it is really strong. We're doing no damage. Is that just me? Are we just not doing any damage? Am I crazy? Is Yelan getting the vapes? I'm a little confused. I mean, Yela's probably gonna do more than my KLEE, to be perfectly honest with you, but like, that is weird. I don't really understand how this interaction is working. Alright, well, I wouldn't call it incredible, but it's working. As long as it's working, I'm okay with that. I think there's a world in which I actually don't join me a skill, because there are pyro ones here, but— Oh my god! Okay, we have to restart. I don't think it's a matter of Kira's shields being too weak. I actually think they're just running out, like, timer-wise, because I'm doing her at the start. Let's actually do it like this. Like, reset her. Now, how do I kill these? Versus the weakness of my team! Please die. Stop wasting my time, man! Okay. Oh my gosh, my energy is so bad. There's a lot of enemies you're not supposed to be using pyro against this. Spiral, huh? I didn't really think about this. It didn't, like, cross my mind that that's why I was struggling with KLEE a little bit until just now. But that explains a lot, actually. Not that we care. Not that that's gonna stop me. Oh, my shield. I don't think Kira was the play. As funny as it is.
I actually think Diona on this side was the play, or something.
Just because I need the help. Oh, I'm gonna die.
No!
I was so close. Okay, now we can start kind of actually playing the game. All right. The conditions are now. God damn it. It's so strange. It is actually Yelan getting the vapes. Which isn't a huge deal. It's just weird for me to see. I mean, it's kind of a huge deal, actually, but I think it's fine. Ooh, we don't do anywhere near enough damage, though. Oh my goodness, dog! Yeah, I don't know. It might just be my KLEE's not strong enough, and it might just be I'm not playing it properly. But yeah, we're not really doing much damage. I don't know. It probably would have helped if I played a better team on this half, because then I would have more time for KLEE as well, instead of whatever this nonsense I'm doing is. But it is very funny, so I'm okay with that. Uh-oh. Well, I'm gonna die. Goodbye, cruel world. Never mind, I somehow live.
I live, bitch.
Whew. Oh my god, brother. Oh my goodness. No, I'm done. I'm done. So I know KLEE is getting the, KLEE is giving other people Vaporize because of her skill. Like, that's probably why I keep getting so much Pyro Aura. So maybe what we can do is actually use Overload? Which sounds kind of whack, but it might actually be the play. Yeah, you know, typical Overload team, right? Like, this is what it looks like normally, right? Right? What's a Beto? We're gonna take this half seriously this time. No more fun. I think I still take the HP, though. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, I shouldn't have done all this. Oh, well. Okay, this is stupid. What am I doing? Also, I know that Gaia doesn't snapshot, so why did I do it this way? I don't know what I'm doing. Ow. But her burst does snapshot, so why did I do this? I don't know, dog. Whatever. Does Raiden snapshot? I kinda doubt it. Out. This isn't a KLEE team anymore. This is not a KLEE team anymore. This is just Raiden, but stupid. It's okay. KLEE dealt the final blow, so clearly it's a KLEE team, right? Ugh. Neat. We had to play it a little carefully there, but as long as it works. This team is so stupid. What am I doing? I mean, it works. It's kind of a real thing. It helps that our team on the other half is a lot better, of course. This is definitely the worst team I've ever tried to clear Spiral with, I think. And I do random teams on, like, a regular occasion. This is so bad. What am I doing? This is so stupid. I think we could full clear. This is so stupid. What am I doing? Whatever. Oh my god, are we really gonna full clear Spiral with this garbage? Alright, Luckily, Yoimiya has the range where I can keep attacking even if I don't have a shield. Her rotation's kind of in an awkward order right now, but it's okay. We'll just hit them hard enough, it doesn't matter. Bye. Wait, how do I break this? I think KLEE can break it, right? But like, I didn't even think about that. That just happens to be something that KLEE can do, not so much something I planned for. Okay, let's do this. Thank God we have so much extra time. We're gonna need it. Wait, my jump cancels are crazy now! My jump cancels are unbelievable now! Okay. Do this to phase through a lot of that damage. Thank you, KLEE. You're actually kind of vital to this team, now that I think about it. I mean, okay, I'm definitely, like, underplaying how much KLEE is doing. She's actually kind of crazy. Oh, whoa. Oh, God. Oh, I tried to dodge through. Damn. Sorry, KLEE. I really want to finish this with you. Alright, Raiden. Booba Sword! Yeah, that's definitely the worst team I've ever full cleared Spiral with. That's crazy. So what did we learn today? I don't know how to play KLEE. I have no idea what I'm doing. But it was good enough to full clear Spiral on both sides, so I guess we did something right. Like, I know Burgeon is just, like, the end-all be-all, which is, it just felt too straightforward, so I wanted to try something different, but oh well, I guess that's just kind of what we ended up relying on. Hope you enjoyed this one. I do plan on trying to get every character in here at some point, so we'll get some interesting teams, I'm sure. I don't know how we're gonna end up getting this all done, but we'll make it work. Anyway, stay safe, stay healthy, I'll catch you when I catch you. Goodbye, YouTube! Goodbye!